सर्व मंगल मांगल्ये शिवे सर्वार्थ साधिके शरण्य त्रयंबेके गौरी नारायणी नमोस्तुते।
हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम योर फ्रेंड मिरल। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू ए गुड मॉरल एंड इंटरेस्टिंग स्टोरी विच इज फ्रॉम पंचतंत्र। आई होप यू मे लाइक इट वेरी मच एंड टेक ए गुड मॉरल फ्रॉम दिस स्टोरी। The story name is Can You Trust Man? Let's start the story.
Once upon a time, there lived a poor Brahman. One day, his wife said to him, "Our children are starving. Don't you think you should do something to satisfy their hunger? Go wherever you have to, but get something for them to eat." The Brahman left his house to get some food for his wife and children. He walked out of the village and soon reached a forest. The Brahman was feeling thirsty. As he was looking around for a stream or a river to quench his thirst, he suddenly noticed a small well. The Brahman went to the well and peeped into it. And what did he see? There was a tiger, a snake, a monkey, and a man in the well. When the tiger saw the Brahman looking down into the well, he said, "Oh Brahman, please help me get out of the well." The Brahman said, "I can help you come out of the well, but what if you kill me afterwards? I promise that I will not kill you," said the tiger. The Brahman helped the tiger come out of the well. The tiger thanked the Brahman, then pointing to a hill, he said, "Do you see that hill over there? I live in a cave at the foot of that hill. Whenever you need me, please come to me. You have saved my life. And I am indebted to you. I will be glad to help you." Saying this, the tiger bowed to the Brahman and walked away. The monkey, who was still in the well, said, "Oh Brahman, please help me too." The Brahman helped the monkey come out of the well. The monkey pointed to a big tree and said, "I live in that tree. Whenever you need me, do come to me. You have saved my life and I am indebted to you. I too will be glad to help you." Saying this, the monkey jumped onto a branch of a tree and left. Meanwhile, the snake, who was still in the well, called out to the Brahman and said, "Oh Brahman, please help me get out of the well." "Oh, I'm scared of you," said the Brahman. The snake said, "Do not fear me. We do not bite without a reason. Who knows, someday I may be helpful to you." The Brahman helped the snake come out of the well. The snake thanked the Brahman and said, "Whenever you are in trouble, think of me. I will at once come to your help." At last, the Brahman was about to help the man come out of the well, but the snake stopped him saying, "Don't help the man come out of the well. Don't ever trust man." Having said this, the snake went away. The man, who was still inside the well, called out to the Brahman and said, "Oh Brahman, you helped all the animals come out of the well. I am a human being. Why don't you help me get out of the well?" The Brahman pitied the man. He helped him come out of the well. the man said to the Brahman, I am a goldsmith. Whenever you want to sell or buy gold, come to me. The Brahman wandered here and there in search of food, but he did not find anything to take home for his children. He then decided to seek the help of the monkey. The monkey gave the Brahman some fresh and juicy fruits and said, You may take fruits from me every day. The tiger's cave was also near that tree. Let me meet the tiger too, thought the Brahman. As he walked towards the cave, let me see how eager he is to help me. The tiger gave the Brahman some golden ornaments and said, These ornaments belong to a prince whom I had killed. They are no use of me, but I know that they will be very useful to you, so you can take them. The Brahman was delighted. He thought, Now let me go to the goldsmith to sell these golden ornaments. I will get a lot of money for them, and then I can live comfortably and happily with my family. The Brahmin went to the goldsmith and showed him the golden ornaments, which he wanted to sell. The goldsmith was surprised. He could not believe his eyes. I had made these ornaments for the prince, he said to himself. He then took some time to think. Sit here and wait for me, he said to the Brahman. I have to go out, but I will return soon. The goldsmith took the ornaments and went to the king. He showed him the prince's ornaments. The king at once said, Oh, these are my son's ornaments indeed. Where did you find them? The goldsmith said, A Brahmin wants to sell these ornaments to me. I have asked him to wait at my house. I think the Brahmin must have killed the prince. Meanwhile, the poor Brahmin was still waiting for the goldsmith to return. Suddenly, the king's soldiers came there and arrested him. They tied him up with a rope and presented him before the king. When the king saw the Brahmin standing before him, he flew into a rage. Put him into the prison and send him to the gallows tomorrow morning, said the king, ordering his soldiers. Sitting in the prison, the Brahman thought of the snake. At once, the snake appeared before him. The Brahman narrated his story to the snake. The snake thought of a plan and said, I will bite the queen. Except you, no one will be able to remove the poison from her body. The queen will regain consciousness only by your touch. This will please the king, and he will pardon you. As planned, the snake went into the queen's chamber and bit her. There was commotion in the place. Many hakims, vaidyas, and even sorcerers were summoned to the place. But none succeeded in his effort to bring the queen back to consciousness. At last, the king issued a proclamation to search for a man who could save the queen's life. The Brahman, who was in the prison, said, I can save the queen's life. He was immediately taken to the queen. The Brahman gently touched the queen's hand, and lo! There was a miracle. The queen instantly regained her consciousness. She opened her eyes. When the king saw that the Brahmin had saved the queen's life, he was beside himself with joy. He was very pleased with the Brahmin. The king duly honored the Brahmin and said politely, O Brahmin, you have saved my wife's life. And I am indebted to you. You are indeed a great man. Now tell me how you got my prince ornaments. Please oblige me by telling me the truth. That would help me find out the cause of my prince's death and also punish the one who has tried to frame you for his death. The Brahman narrated his whole story to the king. Once again, the Brahmin thought of the snake. When the snake appeared before him, the Brahman thanked him for saving his life. When the king came to know that it was the snake who had prevented him from doing injustice to the Brahman, he honored the snake too. He then told them about the Brahman's experience with the monkey, the tiger, and the snake. The next day, the king summoned the court. He invited all the people of the kingdom to attend his court. Then he asked the assembly, "Can you trust animals like the monkey, the tiger, and the snake?" "Yes," said the assembly in unison. "How should I punish the goldsmith who tried to frame the Brahmin for the prince's death?" asked the king. "He should be put into the prison," said the assembly. The king sent the cunning goldsmith to prison and rewarded the Brahmin with a bag of gold coins.
Notifications. I will be bringing a new story with a new moral.